Sasha, and in today's video, I'm bringing you all my nighttime routine. Plus, throughout the video, I'm including some DIYs and life hacks. I really hope you guys enjoy it, and without further ado, let's just go ahead and get started. So my nighttime routine starts off with me coming home, setting down my bag, and then heading to the kitchen to get something to eat, because I'm usually pretty hungry around this time. And before I make something, I usually go on Instagram to help give me some inspiration for something to make. And today I was inspired to make freshly squeezed lemonade because it sounded so bomb. Plus we have two lemon trees in our backyard that are full of lemons, so I decided I needed to take advantage of that. And if you love lemonade just as much as I do, I have a little lemon cutting life hack. And that is to cut your lemons vertically instead of horizontally. You will get way more juice out of your lemons this way. After juicing my lemons, I realized there were lots of seeds in the juice, so I used a strainer to help separate the seeds from the juice. And in order to make my lemonade sweet, I put some water in a pot and put that over the stove and added some sugar. And then I let the sugar dissolve into the water and then added that back into the lemon juice. And this tasted so good. If you want to see the exact recipe I used, I'll have a link to it in the description box. And you can't have a cute glass of lemonade without having cute coasters to go with it. So here are the things you'll need to make the cutest coasters ever. You'll need some cork, an X-Acto knife, some paint colors of your choice, a paper plate, a compass, some paint brushes, and some easy tear tape. Then off camera, I cut out a section of cork from the roll of cork I had, and I actually ended up cutting myself with the X-Acto knife, so definitely be careful if you're trying to do this. But then I took my compass and I traced some circles onto the cork. You can do whatever shape you want, but I decided to do circles, and then I took my X-Acto knife again, being very, very cautious, and cut out the circles. If your craft store has pre-cut cork that comes in circles, or cork that comes in sheets, definitely use that. It will be much easier, but my store didn't have it. And then I took the easy tear tape and laid it down under the cork in different weird zigzag patterns, and I realized the more random I got with it, the better they turned out. Next, I took the different colored paint and painted the cork, then removed the tape to reveal perfectly clean cut lines. I was actually really nervous that the paint would bleed through the tape, but it didn't, and they turned out super cute, and I couldn't be happier. My last orders were called was when she stood on the stool after dancing to Kaylee singing to trad tunes. I never heard Carrick Fergus ever sung so. After making the most refreshing refreshment ever, I decided to have some dinner, and today my family and I ordered pizza, so I just took a slice and ate that on the couch. And lucky for me, I was joined by my cute little dog, Teddy, but I'm thinking the only reason he actually sat with me was because of the pizza. But you know what? Even if he only sat with me for my pizza, I'm okay with it because he is the cutest thing ever. Dinner, it is time for me to get ready for bed. So first I just took out my hair, and today I just had the top of it pulled back, held with some bobby pins. And I constantly find myself losing my bobby pins, so here is a really easy way to store them. All you'll need is a little piece of magnetic tape. I just took the tape and taped it to the inside of my cabinets in my bathroom, and the bobby pins stuck to it, and there you have it. Easy bobby pin storage. Now it is time to hop in the shower, and if you have ever owned shaving cream before, you know how it can cause rings of rust inside your shower, and an easy way to prevent this is to use the lid of a Pringle jar. I know that sounds really weird, but if you set one of these in the corner of your shower and put the shaving cream on top, you will have the perfect rust stopper. And if you guys would like to know what products I use on my skin and in my hair, then let me know in the comments down below. But I do have a quick shower life hack for you, and that is to only apply conditioner to the ends of your hair. This will help prevent greasy roots. Now keep in mind, I will also remove all of my makeup in the shower. Once I'm out of the shower, I will use my wet brush and brush through my hair. And then I used this DIY lip scrub I made, and obviously I chose the pink one because, come on, pink is my favorite color. And here are the things you'll need to make these. You will need some coconut oil, measuring cups, containers, sprinkles, and toothpicks. And sprinkles actually work just as well as sugar because they're tiny and they're the same size as a sugar crystal. Plus, they come colored, so why not? And all you need to do is fill the container with a 1-to-1 ratio of sprinkles to coconut oil. Then you'll mix that together with a toothpick, and there you have it, DIY lip scrub. So all I did for the lip scrub was dip my ring finger into the scrub and then apply that to my lips and then wipe it off with some tissues. And by the end of the day, my room is usually a mess, so after the shower, I will take the time to tidy up my room. And if I'm being completely honest, I'm usually in a rush in the morning, so I will have makeup and makeup brushes everywhere. So here is a really cute DIY makeup brush holder. All you will need is a sushi mat, some cute ribbon, some scissors, some elastic, and of course, makeup brushes. All I did was take the elastic and put it through the little bamboo straws, and every single little loop that I did, I would take the brush and put it there to see how much space it would take up, and then put the elastic through under the bamboo. I don't know if that made any sense. Then you will just fill it with your makeup brushes and you can roll it up, and there you have it, a perfect DIY makeup brush holder. And usually by this time, I'm craving sweets because I have the biggest sweet tooth ever. And here is how you can make ice cream with one ingredient. Yes, I said one ingredient, and all you'll need is bananas. Now, if you don't like bananas, then this recipe is definitely not for you. But I personally like them, so this was perfect. All you need to do is chop up your banana, put it in a plastic container, and freeze it for at least 2 hours. And then you put the bananas in the blender, blend it, and scoop it into your cup, and you have the perfect banana ice cream. I was honestly so shocked at how good this tasted because I kind of doubted it at first, to be honest, but it was really good. And so then I'll just go into my room, sit down on my papasan chair, watch some YouTube, and eat the ice cream, and just take it easy for a little bit. Once I'm done doing that, I will go into the bathroom to brush my teeth, and then I'm almost ready for bed. But first, I need to plug in my phone, that way it's fully charged in the morning. And one tip I have is to put your phone on airplane mode before bed, because I always turn my ringer on and turn my volume all the way up when I'm setting my alarm, but I don't like to hear the noise of the ding, 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 ding of my notifications throughout the night, so I always turn on airplane mode so I don't get disturbed. And I also recommend you leave your phone on the other side of the room, that way you aren't tempted to check it every single second. I actually sleep in my loft, so I just leave my phone on the floor and I'm not distracted. And that is all for my nighttime routine. Well, I really hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, definitely give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel by clicking the big red subscribe button down below. And I also thought I would let you all know that I am beginning to vlog again. Yes, that's right. I'm attempting to post weekly vlogs on my vlog channel, Sasha Morga Vlogs. That way you guys can see behind the scenes and keep up to date with my everyday life. I will have a link to my vlog channel in the description. That way you guys can head over there, check it out, and maybe subscribe because it would be appreciated. And if you haven't already, definitely go follow me on all of my social media. I've got Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, Musical.ly, plus a whole bunch more, so make sure to go follow me on everything. Well, that just about wraps up this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye, deuces.